idea that every person suffering from cancer or some other deadly disease is doing so because they have committed some bad deeds in their past lives, this idea itself is deeply wrong and flawed. Diseases, as the sages tell us, have many causes, one of which is past karma. Karma is merely one out of the innumerable possible causes. What's more, it is quite impossible for an ordinary person to determine whether the cause behind theirs or somebody else's cancer is truly past bad karma. In fact, whenever a person is going through bad times, it is not possible to know with certainty whether their suffering is necessarily due to their past bad karma. This is because the lines of karma of all past good and bad actions of a person are extremely complex and interwoven with one another. They are extremely difficult to trace, and hence simplistic and linear conclusions cannot be drawn and should not be drawn. Such expertise is possessed by God-realized sages. They certainly have the power to untangle the entanglement and know for sure whether past bad karma is the cause. Such sages, of course, are rare. It is for this reason that the Bhagavad Gita has stated, Gehna Karmano Gati. The law of karma works in a deeply complex and indecipherable manner, far beyond the comprehension of ordinary human beings, and therefore we must not commit the mistake of drawing simplistic linkages and blame past karma for each and every bad thing that happens to us or to others. The difficulties of life, in fact, have many non-karmic causes. For example, it may be the case that the soul of a person has purposely charted out difficulties in its life plan so that the person can grow and manifest the divine qualities which lie latent within and thus hasten their ascendancy to the realm of God consciousness. In other words, the inner self of a person can purposely invite difficulties and use them as tools to quicken the pace of spiritual growth. When this happens, the individual himself will not be aware of this decision made by his inner subconscious self. Another example of life's difficult situations having non-karmic causes is when an individual becomes the victim of another person's evil thoughts and actions. When we are born on earth, we each take birth in a realm of deep ignorance, where we and others around us are all ignorant of our true divine natures. Thus, we go about committing numerous mistakes, acts of bad judgment and evil deeds. Living in this realm of ignorance, we can easily become the victims of another person's misdeeds. Consider, for example, the case of a farmer who's illiterate and who routinely sprays pesticides on his fruits. A pesticide company whose executives are all highly educated but morally weak, these executives, blinded by the greed for profits, market their product aggressively to this illiterate farmer. The farmer, being uneducated, is not equipped with the knowledge to understand the harms caused by pesticide use. The government health officials too have taken bribes from the pesticide company and have consequently turned a blind eye to the scientific warnings of toxicity. As a result of all these moral lapses, some consumers, after ingesting the pesticide-laced fruits purchased from the farmer, get cancer. Past karma then cannot be blamed for their contracting the disease, because these individuals are in reality the victims of other people's bad judgment, ignorance, greed and immorality. Therefore, it is very important for us to keep in mind that diseases and bad events in life have many causes and past karma is not always to be blamed. Furthermore, because the workings of the law of karma are extremely complex, therefore it is not possible for us to pinpoint and know for sure whether somebody's disease or ill luck is really due to their past bad karma. In fact, it is a good thing that the workings of the law of karma are hidden and secret. For if they become knowable to one and all, people would immediately lose their empathy and become hard-hearted and cold to the suffering of others. So next time you see a person suffering, don't immediately jump to thinking that karma is the cause. But remember the words of Sri Krishna from the Gita, Gehna Karmano Gati. The workings of the law of karma are mysterious and extremely complex, and therefore simplistic linkages cannot and should not be drawn.